A chest radiograph is a radiographic imaging technique used for the assessment of the heart, lungs, and structures within the thoracic cavity. We created this video to cover the medical definition and provide a brief overview of this topic. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. It goes without saying that it's a requirement for respiratory therapists to know when a chest X-ray is indicated and how to interpret the results. That is because thoracic imaging provides a lot of information about a patient's condition and helps with the diagnosis of respiratory diseases. As previously mentioned, a chest radiograph occurs as an X-ray passes through the chest to a film, which provides us with a visual representation of the structures within the thoracic cavity. The appearance of the X-ray depends on the density of the structures within the chest, which could include air, fat, soft tissue, bone, and fluid. Lungs that are filled with air have a more black appearance on the chest X-ray, which is known as being radiolucent. On the other hand, structures such as bones or fluid absorbs more of the X-ray beams during the process and displays more white on the chest X-ray, which is known as being radiopaque. In general, a chest radiograph must be ordered by a physician, although it often comes by suggestion from a respiratory therapist. Some of the most common indications for obtaining a chest radiograph include the following: dyspnea, acute chest pain, a decrease in oxygenation, hemoptysis, excess sputum production, a severe persistent cough, and for diagnostic measures such as a positive tuberculosis skin test. Chest radiographs are also needed to confirm the proper placement of things such as an endotracheal tube, pulmonary artery catheter, or central venous catheter. The anatomic structures that can be visualized on a chest X-ray include the following: bones, which include the ribs, clavicles, and vertebrae; soft tissues, which includes the chest wall, abdomen, and lymph nodes; lungs, including the trachea, bronchi, and lung tissue; the pleura, as well as the pleural spaces; and a chest X-ray also provides visualization of the lower neck as well. Chest radiographs are great, but they do have their limitations, which is why other imaging techniques are useful if more anatomic details are required. Some examples include a CT scan, MRI, VQ scan, PET scan, and an ultrasound, each of which we have covered in separate videos here on our channel. The results of a chest X-ray are now uploaded digitally and electronically directly to a patient's medical record, which allows multiple medical professionals to assess the findings all at the same time, including radiologists, general physicians, respiratory therapists, and even nurses in some cases. Again, for this video, we just wanted to provide you with a brief overview of this topic. We'll be breaking it down into much more detail in a separate video. Real quick, guys, do me a huge favor and hit the like button. It really helps support the channel and I greatly, greatly appreciate it. And while you're down there, go ahead and click the subscribe button as well, because we have a ton of other videos on our channel that I think you will enjoy. Just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for educational and informational purposes only. And if you want to dive deeper and learn more about this topic, you can go to respiratorytherapyzone.com, where we have a ton of free study guides, practice questions, and other helpful resources. I'll drop links to everything you need right below this video down in the description. Thank you so much for watching all the way to the end. Have a blessed day, and as always, breathe easy, my friend.